Blackstone presents Firefly, Coup de Grâce by Una McCormack. This book is read by James Anderson Foster and Emily Lawrence.
For Amy H. Sturgis. 1. From the Journal of Anne Imelda Roberts. You may call it unlikely that a girl of my age and size might find herself out in wild country, chasing her daddy's killer with a cut-price, ragtag band of rebels. And if you won't take my word, there's always the sheriff's report, should you care to read that kind of thing. My name is Anne Imelda Roberts, Annie, to those who care to call me friend, and I was 18 years old when the events I describe here occurred. 18 years old. Suddenly, all on my own, unsure who I could count upon. Turns out friends can be found in unexpected places, and don't always look the way you might expect. If there's a lesson to this story, then perhaps that's what I learned. But that is starting at the end, and perhaps I should start at the beginning. Our family was an old one on Abel. Daddy's granddaddy came here when the world was opening up, and made a tidy fortune, and none of us have squandered it, though my daddy's pockets were deep when he saw folks in need. I have been left more than comfortable, and there are still many on Abel right now who cannot say that. My daddy, Isaac Roberts, was Abel-born and Abel-bred, which counts. I don't hold those few years away at the Corps against him, and nor should you. On the contrary, the Corps was where he met Mama, Alicia, and if he hadn't met Mama, they wouldn't have had me. I call that a blessing. Other folks have opinions of their own. There are some in Yell City right now who might say that my being born was a good thing, and others might say something to the contrary, but those are the kind of folks always looking to blame another for their bad fortune. I'll say this now, and let me be plain. None of what happened over those few days was my fault. And if people expected me to behave any differently, they didn't know my mama, and they certainly didn't know my daddy. Daddy was a good man, by which I mean he trusted people who were not worthy of his trust. I will never make that mistake, and I would say that the events of those few days have proven to me the wisdom of this. Mama, when she was alive, used to say that Daddy was a fool to everyone and himself most of all. She was in no way a mean woman. Quite the contrary. In fact, everyone always said she was like summer in the mountains. But I suspect that even she must surely have found Daddy a trial at times. Always taking on cases that wouldn't bring in a penny because of some sob story or other. A big heart, people said to me after he died. As if that's enough to pay one's way in the world. Enough to protect you from those whose hearts have shriveled away to nothing. Maybe I should start with the last few days of my daddy's life, even if that comes painful to me. And to tell you about those days, I must make clear straight away that Daddy was, above all, a man of the law. He loved the law, by which I mean laws made by men and women, and seeing the right thing done was the centerpiece of his life. Well, the truth of this verse is that there ain't no law but God's law, and that truth isn't always clear. In the end, what is clear is my daddy was not wise to put his trust in the law of mortals. In the end, we all stand before our Heavenly Father, and it is by him that we are held account for all we have said and done in our days. What I will say, however, is that sometimes there's no harm in giving his law a helping hand along the way, as I believe this tale of mine, once told, will show. My daddy went to the Corps to do his training, and when he came home to Abel, bringing Mama, he set up in Yell City. At first, folks were not sure what to make of him. Abel born, yes, but sent off to the Corps to do his studying and coming back with a Corps-born wife. In the early days, persuading people to let him represent them was a struggle. That changed when he defended a group of folks living in one of them tenements down near the space docks who were under threat of eviction. They didn't have anything to...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.